Bonjour, bonjour, fragrance lover. Welcome back to my channel. Today, I want to present you, as you've seen in the little introduction, a brand that I don't know if you know. It's called Saint Salim. So I've been lucky enough to receive some products from them, which I really like. So I want to share with you this experience. So just a little bit presentation, in case you don't know the brand. Saint Salim is a UK perfumery store. It's, I think you've got one in Leeds, as I remember. It's been created by Ilya Salim in 2007. And as I think, it's like kind of like a family business, which is, I think, incredible. So Saint Salim is a store that's got niche fragrance and Arabian kind of like perfume. You've got some oud sprays, you've got body oil, really like raw ingredient to discover. So it's really like a really cool like perfumery store and you can discover a lot. And recently they've been like just created also their own scent, and this is what I'm gonna show you today. They're based on natural oil, natural ingredient, and they are sourced in Asia and Middle East. So the fragrance that I'm showing you today are unisex, so it can be also worn by ladies and men. So it's totally a different way to use fragrances with Saint Salim. It's like an oriental ritual, which is very different from, I would say, Europeans or anything like more occidental. It's based on oil, layering. This is something that has been like creating a long time in the Arabian culture. It's more like an intimistic ritual, so usually I layer the oil on my pulse point, over there. And I use a spray, so it can be a different brand to add a little bit like a more like layering, or it can be Saint Salim spray, so it really depends. But to be honest, so the first time I received Saint Salim like oil, I didn't know the brand at all. And I was like, I was not keen on roll-on oils, because every time I've been trying, it's been not lasting on me. So usually it's like a nice little scent, but it doesn't stay and I need something very opulent. So usually it does not work. Well, I've tried the oil on me and trust me, it's extremely long lasting. So you definitely have enough with the oil, but I would always recommend to have a spray as well. So they propose the same scent in oil and spray, some of them. So this is really cool actually. So the first one that I want to show you, this one. So this is called Moroccan Musk. It's one of my favorites, so I wanted to show you in the first side. So you've got the oil like this. So I'll show you a closer. So you've got Saint Salim just written here. It's like this. And then usually this one I apply, or actually I applied it this morning, so I can do it again. I apply it here, and what I do is I rub them together. So you don't usually do that with fragrance, but with oil, the more you will rub it, the more really it smells, like the smells really develop with the warmth, which is really nice. So Moroccan Musk being created in 2013, is created by the Salim family. Again, so it's warm, sweet notes, a bit of musk, floral notes at the base, something like that. It's very cocooning, very mysterious scent, and for me it's like ultra sexy. It's quite soft, this one. You really can smell the sweet notes in there, but it's not sweet. It's like a sweet oriental scent, vanilla like but not too much. It's not overpowering. But the stays on this oil is just crazy. So like I was saying to you, usually what I do is I do that. I apply a bit on there as well. And then what they've been created, which I think is amazing, is the same scent, Moroccan Musk, but in a spray. Look at this little bottle. I can clearly see an inspiration with this bottle, if you know what I mean. But yeah, beautiful little bottle, matte color. And what I do is usually I spray on top. So then you've got the spe- ah, I think I- oh, nice. So the two together are perfectly like are going well together, and the fact that the spray I feel is a little bit like more softened, like I don't know, more floral maybe. I'm not sure, but it's a bit more hairy. So the two together, when you move like and you go through the day, like you can really like smell it. Do you know, it's nice when you're actually moving to smell your fragrance on you. So this is what it does. To tell you a little thing, this one, when I had it, I first sprayed it because you know, I opened the box, I was like, oh, okay, let's see. Smelled it, I was like, I was so tired this day, but I was like, oh my god, I think I like sprayed so much time before going to bed. But yeah, so this is a really really nice scent. If you're looking something oriental, a bit sexy, charming, mysterious for humans, you know, like I don't know, like I would love someone to wear that. It's beautiful, the two of them is really stunning. When I wear those kind of fragrance, I want to wear like you know, like a dark liner on the waterline, you know, to give that, I don't know, the vibe. Bunny! Bunny! Nice. Thank you, Madeline. So, the next one I wanted to show you is called London Hood. I find it so amazing that it's called London Hood. And it's funny because the first time I smell it, I really make me feel of London. A kind of oriental London, but London. You know, it's very cosmopolitan in London, so... So the first time I smelled that, it smells very spicy, woody, ambery still. So you've got this oriental base, but this one is really yummy. It's really spicy, but it's not smell like, you know, the smell of coriander, a bit like of... bitterness to it, and it's really interesting. So you know, just like you're going to a restaurant and you smell those kind of scent, like Indian restaurant or stuff like that. And there's a scent that made me think also like a pine tree, you know, like fresh but like a bit mossy and a bit like a foresty. But I would say this is something that we're more used to scent on a man. I did wear it a lot because still there's something like very like deep inside and warm. It's very elegant. It's got, I would see someone with a lot of charism wearing this one. And again, this one I wore it completely alone and it was enough, literally was enough. And I think you have it for extremely long time, just this amount, like you do like easily like a few months, and you have to use it every day, so it's really really good value. So it nearly smells like a bit like of aftershave as well. So if you like fougère accords, you know, like a green aromatic kind of freshness, you've got things like Platinum Egoist from Chanel that are like that, or you've got some Diptyque as well, or the Minté that are like that. So you know, those kind of scent that smells like a bit like mossy, things like that. So there's a very deep background, and I think it's one of the most powerful I've tried from the brand. And yeah, it makes me think of the street of London, because it always smells food, and we always like to eat spicy and things like that. But yeah, lots of charism, like a man with a suit, you know. Oh, beautiful. Another scent that I have, which is quite different for this one. So this is amber. This, so the color of an amber, beautiful color as well. Look at this, look at this, interesting. And I thought for the one that really want to learn about fragrances, it's really interesting to have pure ingredient like this. So amber is an accord, so it's different ingredient mix it together. It's a bit like vanilla-like, but spicy at the end. You can mix that with all your oriental fragrance, which I think is nice. Usually with this one, again, I layer it over there, a little bit over there. And what I do, I take any oriental after that I have, and it's perfectly like complement that amber scent. Like this, that is nice with it. Cartier, La Panthère, that is nice as well. Oh yeah, a little Boucheron with it was really nice. Yeah, even like Tom Ford, Santal Blush, why not? Jo Malone. It's not like a simple amber, like this is really deep and there's something like a very structure. And I always think that if you want to feel more unique and special, like having to layer with an oil like that is actually the best idea you could have. What is annoying me sometimes is I have so many fragrances that sometimes I don't smell them anymore, so I need something like very strong. And this actually really helped me to smell my fragrance on me, like smell it when I'm moving, even after a few hours. This, with this kind of thing, I always smell it. And I think if you experience that problem, I think we all did if you we like fragrances, I would recommend you to do that. Creed of Friday, what a nice name. Body oil, so this is made from natural oil, argan oil, olive oil, black seed oil, premium scents made in the UK. So I think I've seen on the website that you can use that on the beard for the men, so to moisturize your beard and feel it like more comfortable. It's got a beautiful scent. So again, I would say like, I mean, I'm saying more masculine, but for me, no. I mean, every time I'm go out of my shower, this is what I apply to my body, my legs and everything. And it smells slightly like citrusy, fresh, but there's something like spicy, moisturize, and even to use that as body layering, more citrusy, that's nice. Like for layering, like I would probably put that first, and then why not like putting like an early Portofino after, like something very fresh, that can be really nice actually. So yeah, so that's this one. Then there's something very interesting, so I will like put it in the same category as the amber I showed you, because this is really nice for layering. This is a pure ingredient again, and this is musk. And this is, when I've seen that, I was like, if you're a fragrance connoisseur, or if you know a bit about fragrance, you know that white musk is the best ingredient for layering, because it gives like a clean and like plain surface for your fragrance to be layered with. And white musk has got an amazing power, is when you spray your fragrance on top of white musk, it will attract the most powerful ingredient and would make it much more softer and rounder. So it's really interesting ingredient for fragrance lover. And when I've seen it, I was like, oh my god. And that is quite funny, because so you apply it with this, like this, look at this. Musk smell extra clean. So it's not only like you got off your clothes from the washing machine, you can layer that with something like quite woody or a bit mossy, you know, things like that. I think that would be nice. Hey, the light is much better like this. Oh, I'm so stupid. So again, if you experience that your scent is changing, your acidity of the skin doesn't allow you to wear like really fragrance, I would say give it a try. It's not always working, but this is helping a lot, trust me. So layering technique with oil like this, especially musk, might help you. It did help me. I'm not saying that's the solution for everyone, but actually this helps. To finish by my favorite oil, so this one I had it from quite a long time now, and this is the thing I always have in my bag all the time. So you know, sometimes I don't want to carry like a big fragrance with me, even though I've got like small one and stuff like that. I don't want to carry like a massive like fragrance with me. So usually what I do is I have this little boy in here. So this is Mexican oud oil. It's really nice because this fits perfectly in my handbag if I go out. And usually, I don't know for you, but I like to respray myself. So this is what I do. I just rub it again, a bit everywhere, in there, everywhere. I fell in love from that the first time I smelled it, ultra long lasting. When I'm moving, I'm smelling it a lot again, like the other one, but this one, it's got much more softer than the other one and a bit more rounder. I think there's more like rose and amber inside, but it's very vintage-like. It's not too opulent, it's delicate, but the scent of it, I don't know how to explain it. It's not really like honeyed. You want more, you know, it's a very charming, sensual, but in a delicate way. So yeah, Oh, I find it so attractive. So it came in this wonderful little packaging like this, which are velvety, very cute, with the logo in there, Saint Salim. The box and presentation are beautiful as well. It's simple but very elegant, and I don't know if you know, but they had the retail business of the year, I think, from 2018, as I've read. So this is something quite important. I would say you can follow them on their Instagram, that I will put just there and there. Yeah, they're always posting really good things, really nice video on their stories, and for being like speaking to them on their Instagram, they're very lovely people, and really nice, really polite, and it's really a pleasure to talk about it very nicely. Tell me in the comments if you already tried Saint Salim, but you can have a go on their website as well if you feel something would interest you. But I really recommend you to try, because if you do love Orient scent like this and this kind of ritual, you love that. So so that's it for me. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna stop my editing and I'm gonna go to bed because I'm so sick. Again, like, thank you for following me. Please subscribe to the video, like it if you did like it, and press the little bell if you want to see more of my videos, and I will be coming back soon. So bye now. If I saw you on the street.